Tone. The tone is your sound, it's your signature sound, and that sound by which you're just hitting one note, or some playing some phrase, you identify immediately, this is Paco de Lucía, this is B.B. King, or this is Pat Metheny, etc. You notice that because they have that sound. Alan Holdsworth also has. Any great master had this characteristic of a particular individual tone, which is like a fingerprint thing, it's your signature. That we have to develop from day one. Since we are beginning from the scratch, from zero, we start developing tone. How? By having proper guidance, of course, and by having an instrument that lives, that brings you to that point. If the guitar you play has no quality, then you cannot develop good tone, and this has very counterproductive results, actually, because you get used to the wrong thing. Suppose if a guitar, instead of sounding like this, has a plastic tone on the trebles or anything, that becomes my point of reference now. And then therefore, this is bad. It's a bad idea. So, not that any guitar you can play, if you play well, you can play any guitar. This is not true, because there is good player with a good guitar, good player with a bad guitar, bad player with a good guitar, and bad player with a bad guitar. Right? And many levels in between. And out of these four options, we have to aspire to be a good player with a good instrument. This instrument, instruments, when especially, and if you're a beginner, even more important is this. You know, when people sometimes think, when I am advanced, I will get a nice instrument. No, that is not how we... You never become advanced by playing a bad guitar. So, because why? Because the tone is intimately related to the instrument you play. You become used to a capacity of tuning that the instrument has. If your guitar doesn't tune, which is almost any bad guitar does not tune, obviously, well, fretboards wrong, mid, etc. These things, you get used to measurements, wrong divisions. I showed, watch the description of this video about the bridge, inconsistencies on the drilling walls in the bridge. This, if you get used to that, this is very bad. Not only you don't become advanced, but this tone thing is far and far and far from you. You have to develop a proper sound, which is very much related to the instrument you play. So, and of course, I'm not saying now buy a Stradivarius or the most expensive guitar of the world, but that you can see according to your budget and to your desire to improve in music, you can get an instrument which is inexpensive and proper to practice, right? Of course, there are no decent guitars of $200, but it's like just like an airplane, maybe cost, I don't know, a jet costs $1 million, and we cannot say, can we get a decent airplane with $10,000? No, of course you cannot get, because this is not the level of that. So then therefore, anyway, when the quality is not there in a guitar, the only thing left to talk about is price. But when quality is there, then price doesn't matter. And I said that not because I'm rich or anything, I'm also just another middle class guy then, but the thing is that the quality is what is important, and for quality is quite, because it's related to your tone, and therefore there are four options also, which is an expensive nice guitar, an expensive bad guitar, like those I could put in the description, watch the first video about these things, flaws, and how to find these flaws, etc., to choose, and then you have inexpensive nice guitar and inexpensive bad guitar. These four options there. Out of these four, at least we should have an inexpensive proper guitar, like the affordable models of Simplicio or any proper instrument which solutions the problem of tone, tuning, playability and everything. Because measurements, what is measurement? Measurements means playability. So your tone also depends on the instrument. In this case, it depends a lot. Imagine, even in electric guitars, it matters, but in acoustic instruments, that you are playing it, your own finger is producing the sound, here there's no electronics, so the world and everything, it matters, of course it would matter that. And then you develop that tone from day one, and if you are a beginner, you get used to proper tone, proper tuning, and proper measurements. This is the advantage. So this tone thing is something we have to aspire, but it's a very big subject. I just pointed out one of the aspects of it. Thank you, and I see you next time.
Muy bien, Pablo. Sí, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo de Andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.
En el libro que descubrí ahí, la improvisación. La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico debería a músicos del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música, debería aprender, porque la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando y cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías están en cada momento, ¿no?